by its nature, is fleeting. We can hold on to impressions and memories, but they too, by their nature, fade. So how do you hold on to a moment? Well, you take its picture, of course. Libby started taking pictures of Spokane around 1898 or 1899. No one's really sure on the exact date. What we are sure of is that Charles Libby and his son took a lot of them. Pictures in the Libby collection by the time Keith Henry bought the studio in 1969.
My first impression was a big, dusty mess.
Probably none of that one, unless I was wondering about how much
it was. It was full of cigarette ashes and soot, and it was just, it was a mess. You broke through it and your hands were dirty. See if there's anything in value and get rid of it.
But something started to change his mind.
I thought, well, there's tons of silver in this. I thought, well, this would be a real gold mine to get rid of the silver. And so I started going through it. And as I went through it, I began to realize, oh, this is recording a lot of history.
And faces stared back at him from the past.
This is history. This is just pure history. This can't be thrown away. That'd be a crime to throw that away.
So he kept the pictures, the only link in some cases to Spokane's long forgotten past. Then 4 years ago, he sold them to the Jeannie Coles Museum, where they're now on display.
They said this is Spokane. This is Spokane, 1900, 1910. What is history? I mean, history is just a record of what's been, you know, what happened.
Spokane phone directory listed Charles Libby as a view photographer, and history has borne that out, a history made up of hundreds of thousands of different moments leading through time, captured by those whose job it was to look.
They say a photograph worth 1,000 words, and I have to say that it's worth more than that.